previously during the operation. Things have gone from bad to worse. First we lose Matt, and now Tom! He wasn't one of the good ones like Matt, but he was the only other person on the team who did anything other than me. Worse still, it looks like Tom was killed by a traitor. Worst of all, the traitor could be any one of us. Except Matt or Tom. I guess Dan couldn't have done it either, unless he's come back from the dead. I hope there's not zombies! Worst of all, the elevator controls were blown up by one of the crying lions. Jake was a huge jerk, too. I said I was sorry. Now we need to meet up with Law and Steve. I hope the traitor doesn't strike again. Well, maybe Jake, but not after that.
Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play WinBack. Last time, already had Jean-Luc cover that. Let's see if we can get out of the damn sewers for this level now. Of course, to get out of the sewer level, you must first go through even more sewer levels. So, we'll, hopefully won't take us too long to get through here. And since we do have to go to a different elevator, hopefully that means that it's not in the same building, because we've been in here for probably about an hour now. Maybe even longer. And just skip right past that room. That room is actually pretty difficult if you decide to take it head on. And this is the part of the game where it starts getting pretty difficult to the point where even the game starts giving you a lot of MP5 ammo. We'll be using this gun way more than before. There's a lot more long-range quarters going on, and there are a lot more enemies. Checkpoints are actually more frequent now, too. One of the main differences between the PS2 and the N64 version is that the PS2 version actually added more checkpoints. The N64 version would start spreading the checkpoints out pretty thin around this area, and this area is not easy. You know, I kind of just realized something. Every time I roll in there, I am rolling Jean-Luc's face into sewage. Sorry, Jean-Luc. He's still upset about the whole elevator thing, so I guess it's some some form of self-punishment. Well, we're out of the sewer, but here's not too much better. How many times have we seen this room now? 5? I don't really like to take too long here, but I do want to slow it down a little bit in this area. Mainly for the fact that one hit from a shotgun will actually kill me. While the checkpoint is really not too far away, I'd still rather just not do this part over again. Again, I still think we're doing pretty well for time, so not a whole lot to worry about if we spend a little extra time going through here. good to take that box out really early, because as you saw, he will actually start pushing it towards you, and they will blow it up beside you. Funny thing though is that the enemy AI doesn't really recognize explosive boxes as a danger to themselves. They don't have any coding that inhibits them from blowing up a box that's right in front of them. They'll just target you through the explosive box and shoot it regardless of whether it's going to kill them or not. So they can actually kill themselves with that box. Not really sure where that guy was going. We will actually not see him again. That third guy below actually tends to bug out quite often. In another run through here, he kind of like sat under the floor trying to shoot me through it. And of course, it's back through this series of runes because, hey, it was hard the first two times. Why not make us go through it a third? And it's still pretty hard. But hopefully, your experience will help you. Then all the MP5 ammo doesn't hurt. You can see how I'm spamming this stuff off really, really fast now. It's pretty common ammunition at this point. Especially since we picked up that ammunition bag at the start. We can just keep on picking up magazines. We don't have to really worry about running out, so we can give ourselves a little extra. Speaking of MP5 ammo, two more magazines down here, which should mean that we would need to use them. Come on! And it really does. I kind of actually get lucky here just using the pistol. Got a shutter there, but I don't want to go through the gas room. Fortunately, we do not have to.
Hurry up, Jean-Luc! What's keeping you?
I'm coming! That door should take us into the old factory section, but it's been sealed shut.
As we speak, Mike is busy setting charges that should blast us a way through.
And that's why we're all just standing here looking at each other.
Oh, that explains it. I thought it was some new kind of group therapy.
Sorry about the wait. It's all set now.
Okay, then let's blow this joint. Mike?
Now you're talking. 3, 2, 1, 0! That did it.
Let's get out of here.
Looks like we have company.
I'll hold him off. The rest of you, keep moving!
Not alone, you won't!
Get going, Lisa!
But...
Lisa, don't forget our mission. We need to find the Gulf controls.
I know that, Jake, but still...
He's upset because of the elevator incident. Give him a chance to make up for that and blow off some steam.
Well, if you say so. Catch up as soon as you can, Jean-Luc.
I plan on it.
Okay, kid. They're all yours.
Thanks, Jake.
Lisa, Mike, Keith, we're moving out.
Group therapy, Jean-Luc. After that blunder at the elevator, I don't think you are entitled to me making sarcastic remarks. And as you can tell from the way that Jake is talking to us, calling us kid and giving everyone else orders, I think he's attempting to usurp leadership of SCAT. Now that Dan's out of the way and Jean-Luc appears weak, scumbag Jake is going to assert his dominance and take over as leader. You know what? When it comes to a squad named SCAT, I think Jake might actually have a chance. Although, going by that reasoning, I guess Jean-Luc just further cemented his leadership position after that elevator incident. But hey, shotgun shells. Got it pretty close with that headshot, but loading screen, so doesn't matter. Apologize in advance for my squeaky chair. Not quite sure what the whole looking around thing was for. Maybe Jean-Luc was looking around for his squad mates, thinking, what the hell? They were only 5 seconds in front of me. No, our guys move fast. Or maybe they just climb over these little containers. Though, I just had a thought. With the locked doors ahead of us, and with our squad always going in front of us, that must mean that our squad is intentionally locking us out behind them. So yeah, I think Jake really is trying to usurp leadership.
Is locked from the other side.
What do you know? Thank you, SCAT members. Come on. Oh. Well, damn. I was trying to melee him in the back, but I guess my camera was tilted just enough towards the wall to where he took cover rather than melee him. Fortunately, we didn't get stun locked this time, so. Ready for small mirror, right? This is kind of a weird area where we can't actually target him unless we are either already standing or have already shot him. And how effective was that last bullet? As much Counter-Strike as I've played in my life, I should not feel so accomplished whenever I get a headshot in this game, but the controls being how they are, I feel like God after every single headshot. Not exactly what you were trying to draw focus to there with that last big game. So, just unlocked that door over there, so I guess that just means we're backtracking already. And wasted no time in recycling this new area. They made a new zone that we're walking through, and damn it, we are going to be using it. You're going to appreciate the hard work that went into the modeling. Well, I don't even know about modeling. They were on a budget, alright. Appreciate their budget work. I will see you guys later.
Freeze!
switch to turn off a laser? I don't think so. Just random water-filled room for something that they decided to hide a key in. I really have no idea. You know, those boxes are pretty sturdy for being able to float in water. Stopping to check. Kind of just want to speed our way through this, and that would be the most absurd thing ever to witness in real life. Man with a shotgun misses 6 shots of somebody doing somersaults at him, who walks up and shoots him in the head. It is an absurd world in WinBack, but Jean-Luc gets by. His secret? Never skipping leg day. Well, that was pretty straightforward, at least. We didn't have to spend too long backtracking in this area. And hey, flashlight! We actually have something new, which is kind of scary in this game. So, as you might imagine, we're going to go through this dark area with the flashlight, but fortunately the flashlight just makes it to where it basically lights up the entire room. So, the necessity of it is really null, to be honest. I believe that it might make enemies a bit more aware of your position, but when aren't they really? I have read several guides that say that the flashlight does make enemies target you more often, but what else are they gonna aim at? Could it be that there is a stealth element to this game and I've just been playing it very, very wrong all this time? Probably not. A little bit of a damage discrepancy there. Sometimes when I get shot, it takes away, you know, like 7 bars. There, I just got shot and it took away 1. I'm gonna find a way to use this rocket. I do like, though, how the flashlight seems to be coming out of the barrel of our rocket launcher. We just stuck it in one of the empty chambers to hold it in there. Imagine how areas are short now, with they're just very hard with frequent checkpoints. That's this zone. That area in the sewer I actually had to do probably about 7 times. And then they pull this, having enemies spawn behind you. Now, they've done this a few times through the game, but at this point, this is where they really start to do it. High damage discrepancy. But it doesn't matter. Save point means full health. We're making decent time as well. Doesn't this room look fun? Last time we had a room like this, they just blew themselves up, and we were safe behind a doorway, but unfortunately, there's not really anything we can do to avoid these explosions, because, as I mentioned earlier, they don't detect explosive barrel or explosive boxes as a danger to themselves. They'll just shoot them to hit you, which is kind of what happened there. Somehow we managed to survive that. Granted, we only survived with 3 bars and then got lucky with a 2-damage bar shot, but checkpoint right outside of that room, so I guess I won't complain. This area is a huge dick. Fortunately, they gave us a checkpoint, and there again, them so graciously demonstrating the fact that they don't give a crap about shooting explosive boxes. But that explosive box up there, if you try to take cover in that green box just ahead of us, they will actually drop that explosive box beside you and blow you up. And there's an enemy spawning behind us. So we have enemies in all directions and an explosive box being dropped on top of us. That is actually probably the most sensible place to keep a key. I suppose this is unlocked. Of course not. I can never keep my health for very long, can I? Alright, screwed. I know we're down to our last few bullets for the MP5, but I'd say that this is a fairly good place to use it. Fortunately, the gun emplacement won't shoot over the boxes, so we just have to avoid the bullets when we're crossing between them. Which isn't actually that hard. Just kill all the people first, and then run on through, so that you won't get hit and staggered. Fortunately, that guy ran out in front of us for whatever reason. And of course, we can't have a machine gun section without us getting to use it. Unless they actually get behind you, they aren't really any threat whatsoever. Especially now that they come out one at a time. That it? You sure? Okay. What do you know? We're actually in the green for our health. I'm sure that won't last long. Huh. Why did they have a medkit there at all? Oh, maybe there wasn't a checkpoint here in the N64 version.
Government scum!
There's a shutter right there. Come on.
Think you're pretty quick, don't you? I'm going to fry the skin right off your bones!
Sorry to disappoint you, but I have another engagement!
Why, you little! This time, you're mine!
This time? Have we met? Now, I was kind of disappointed in the last boss, how it wound up looking really easy, and it was actually pretty hard. When you fight against this guy, it will most likely go something kind of like this. You don't have to watch all that. Or wait. Oh, those rules. Anyway. This boss fight is actually pretty hard until you figure out how to exploit the AI. You you've got two people on each side, one with an MP5, one with a shotgun, who are floating by in those little conveyor belt things. And you have this guy who's chasing you around the flamethrower with explosive barrels and boxes scattered throughout the environment. So, pretty difficult. Up until the point where you realize you can actually outrun the boss and just run circles around it where the enemies cannot hit you. Fortunately, we have some shotgun shells left, and looks like we have just enough shells to actually whittle the boss down. Every now and then just turn around, hit him once, it staggers him, so just keep going and we remain ahead of him. Running around, making it where the enemy can't actually really hit us, especially when we are underneath their gondolas. And this was actually a pretty pathetic boss fight against a pretty pathetically named boss. And in true boss fashion, he just, you know, explodes. For some reason. So, you know, for these guys coming from a country called Sarkozia, they seem to have fairly American accents. So that is one more boss down, and, well, we really don't know how many people the crying lions consist of, so just assume there's gonna be a few more. Assume that there's at least two more for Cecil Carlisle and what's the other guy's name? Kenneth. The least terrorist-y name of all, Kenneth Coleman. It's not entirely sure what pressing that button did. I guess it started up the gondolas. How Jean-Luc knew how to press that button? Well, same as how every other video game character knows what button to press, I guess. This area will ruin your day pretty quick. 3 to 4 shotguns all at once. Pretty nuts, but this is actually a good way to see how the enemy has to reload, just like you. It's kind of interesting in this game how the enemies actually work on a very similar system to you, where they will have the same amount of shots in a magazine. They target you the same way that you target them. The only difference, really, is that they don't use cover. But to be fair, we are rarely using it now to begin with either. Pretty much just rolling everywhere, and that's working out way better than the cover is. It's also a way to show if you shoot an enemy in the back, then it's a one-shot kill. It's a nice feature, though you won't really get to use it too often. Also kind of makes meleeing somebody in the back kind of pointless. I'm not really sure how we got hit there. I honestly have no clue. Sometimes the bullets will just nick your hitbox, and sometimes you'll barely get away. Because Jean-Luc cannot step on the button. Back up and shoot at some. I guess it's good that they made it to where you can't aim straight down, because then you could, that would kind of just give you more distance to travel. It started at the bottom for some reason. Then, you know, don't want you to shoot yourself in the foot, right? I'm not entirely sure why they put all those enemies there, if you can just bypass them like that. Design choice, I guess. Fortunately, since we have one health, this gondola ride is pretty easy. You can see those two little panels off to the side there. If you are fast, then you can shoot one, maybe two of them. Two would be pretty risky. And it will help you out pretty significantly later. Why you would want to shoot these guys when you can just as easily take cover in the gondola? That's because of the fact that when you get over this side, they will actually be persistent. Most enemies are not persistent through loading screens or doorways, but this actually keeps them going. And nuts. Well, that's gonna add a lot of time on. So sorry, Jean. Might as well just do this over, since we have a checkpoint right here. Just for the sake of trying to get the good ending. I'm not entirely sure why they actually have that button to go back. I guess because this one does, and they just kind of copy and pasted one side onto the other. Rather than flip them. Well, that magazine we got didn't last long, but at least it went to good use. So see, on the ride back, the one that I edited out, I actually hit that one laser there. So, if I actually had to hit both of them, then we would have been in trouble. Now, I think you actually have to blow them up. Theoretically, you could crouch in the gondola, and I don't think they would be able to hit you. I'm not really certain on that, because I've never not shot them just to find out. Those gondola rides are pretty tedious, to be honest. I'm sure the scat team knows all about that, because I doubt anybody managed to fit in there with Mike. Oh boy, a rocket launcher. Honestly, I don't get too much use out of these. They're only good for some specific boss fights. You can't take cover with them, and they do really leave you open for attack when you shoot them. Now I know where the locked door is, so I really don't care about these enemies. So no real reason to risk losing any health, and we're doing fairly well. Might as well just keep all of our ammo. I'm not quite sure why those lasers will insta-kill a human, but know, the gondola has no problem going through. Pretty powerful flashlight to be able to go through that steel. And with that, I'm going to call this a part. Got a lot done. Well, not a whole lot story-wise, but made some progress. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. I will see you in the next part. Let's play WinBack.